Right, this is just a quick clip of me peeling the scales off of the fish. Tonight's dinner is snapper, and I'm just trying to show you how I'm getting the scales off of the fish. Get the scales off like this. A bit hard to show for me to show you because I'm trying to peel the fish, and at the same time I've got the flip recording. I need to get a one of those little tripod things for it soon because it's not really convenient for me. Oh, there we are. Right, these are the snapper, so I think it's a pink snapper or something. It's not the silver one anyhow. But I've cut all the fins off, I've gutted it, I've cleaned it, and it's ready to be seasoned. Okay, so I'm just going to put off the camera, season the fish, and then I'm going to put it back on. Well, now I've just got the baking tray. And I put some foil on it, just a sheet of foil. I'm going to sprinkle some oil on it, just about 1 or 2 teaspoons, just to stop the fish from sticking to the oil. I don't really like to use too much oil, and it's just pure sunflower oil. And I'm just going to sprinkle some of that on, and afterwards put the fish on top, just a bit of oil. And as you can see, it's not sort of swimming in oil. I haven't actually finished. I've just cut the onion, which is just over here. And I'm just going to do the next part, and then I'll be back. Right, I just thought I'd quickly record. I'm going to put 1 Scotch bonnet pepper. I'm going to slice that up quite thinly. There's a lemon, just to squeeze on top of it while I'm putting the before I put it in the oven. And then I've got another bell pepper, just like sweet peppers. I've just got the yellow one, but normally you can put the green or you can put red, and you mix it up and just slice that up quite thinly as well, and just sprinkle it on top before you bung it into the oven. I'm going to get some onions as well, so I need to peel the onion. I'll be back. Right, well, the fish is all seasoned and garnished, as you can see, and I'm just going to put it into the oven and bake it for about 25 minutes to half an hour, and then we're going to have it with some potatoes. Okay. Right, these are the Auntie Bessie's potatoes. I mean, normally I'm just making these tonight because it's pretty quick. I mean, you put it in the oven for about 25 minutes and you're ready to go. But I mean, normally you can just make your fresh potatoes, and you can have boiled potatoes. You can put them in the microwave if you want. You can even put them in the oven alongside the fish. But today I'm making Aunt Bessie's, so here it is. Okay, well, this is the fish. It's nearly ready, and I've just taken it out to check it, and I've turned it once already, so I'm just checking to make sure that it's you know, cooking fine before I actually bring out the oven. The potatoes are still in there, so I'm gonna put the fish back in. There's about, I think, 20 minutes left, and they've been in for about 20 minutes already. Okay, these are the potatoes. As you can see, they're slightly brown. I'm just going to turn them over, and then I'm actually going to put them back into the oven just to make sure that they're completely cooked. Sometimes you can just prod them with a little fork to find out if they're properly cooked. Okay, these are the potatoes. They have that golden look. Yeah, and they look just about ready. I mean, if you want them more brown, you can just take off the foil and leave them in for about 10 minutes or so, and allow them to get a bit more brown. This is the steamed fish. It's all ready now. Yeah, you can see that it's ready. That's the oven buzzing, but I've just taken it out. It's actually ready to eat right now. The potatoes, I'm just going to brown them a little bit more, and then we're going to have this with some vegetables, carrots. Okay, thank you. Okay, this is just a finished a video of the finished product, and as you can see, I have put the fish on the plate, and put all the garnish, the onions and the peppers and all that. I mean, it's good as a garnish, and also, I mean, they're vegetables anyway. So you've got your potatoes there. And in fact, I didn't actually make any carrots. I've actually got a salad instead. So I've put the salad in a separate plate, and I've sprinkled it with some seeds, some sesame seeds, and there's one other seed there. So it's just some salad with sprinkled with some lemon juice, bit of salad cream, very, very sparingly. I've got the pumpkin seeds sprinkled on top and mixed in. And I've also got some sunflower seeds as well, sprinkled on top and mixed in. So that gives you added fiber, and it also gives you added vitamins as well, and minerals. So yeah, that's dinner for tonight. Thank you.